Hey guys, what is up? Josh Short here from Edit Video Faster. This video, I'm going to walk you through Avid's auto patching feature. You may notice I'm in a little bit of an older version of Media Composer. I'm pretty darn certain this feature is still around and it works the exact same way. The menu where you turn it on and off, that might look slightly different, but I mean, 99% of this should be relevant for you today, whenever it is that you are watching. So patching, just before we get into auto patching, patching is what we call when we take the source side clip over here and we patch it to the track that we want to edit it into. So over here, this clip in this source side monitor, it has one video track, two audio tracks, and I can decide where I want to edit the clip in. So let's say I have an in and an out point, and just V1 selected over here, put an in point here, no out point, paste the clip in. That's a really long clip. That's how, you know, you edit a clip in. So patching is where we determine which track this goes to. So it was set to V1 before, now I'm set to V4. And there we go, now it pastes to V4. So Avid has this feature called auto patching. Currently it's turned on my system. So when I deselect V4 and I select V2, you see over here this source side, it automatically jumped to V2. I find this really, really useful. You know, I don't even have to think about it. You know, I'm just over here on the keyboard, deselecting V2, selecting V3, don't even have to move my hands from the mouse, hit an endpoint, you know, paste it in. That's all I need to do. My hands never need to go over to the mouse to patch the source side over to the track that I want it to. If you don't like that feature, or if you want that feature and it's turned off for you, go here to an empty spot in the timeline, right click, go to timeline settings, and then here there's two different tabs, display and edit. And again, this might look a little different in a newer version of Media Composer, but I'm pretty certain that it is in here. If it's not, please leave a comment down below so everyone else can find out where this is. But here in the edit tab of the timeline settings, you'll see this auto patching. If you want to turn it off, uncheck it, and then click OK. If you want to turn it on, make sure that it's checked and click OK. I recently did another tutorial about Avid's auto monitoring feature, and this is one that I actually don't like, so I have this one turned off. I'll link that below and, you know, up here in the corner for you to check out if you want to. So that is it. That is auto patching in Avid Media Composer. I hope that you found this useful. If you did, please hit that like button below. And if you want to see more videos like this one, remember to subscribe to that channel. I also have a weekly newsletter that goes out that talks about a topic in the video editing world. And I link to cool tutorials from around the internet as well. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Go drink some water, and I'll see you around in the next video. Bye.